Hello everyone. Now we will solve few questions which are based on the radial line method. In development of surfaces, I told you there are two methods, radial line and parallel line. Parallel line, which we use for the development of a square, prism, or we can say cube or cylinder. But when we have an object which is said to be like pyramid or cone, then we have to apply the radial line. So in this question, I'll teach you how to apply the radial line method. So how will we identify, means which method we have to apply. So the question says that a square pyramid, so pyramid, the type of solid is pyramid. So pyramid, we use radial line method to develop a pyramid. Question says that a square pyramid of base edge 20 mm and axis height 50 mm resting on its base on HP such that its one base edge is inclined at 45 degree to VP. Develop the pyramid. So with this question, I'll teach you how we apply the radial line method and how we develop a object in radial line method. So let's see. Now first of all, what we do, as we have done in the parallel line method, I will try to compare the parallel line with the radial line so that in comparison you can understand, you can remember. So we have to start the same. First, we will draw the XY line. This is VP, HP. We will make the front view, top view, then we will develop just like parallel line method. So it is given in the question, a square pyramid is there. So for a pyramid, square base is there. So what will be the top view? A square, and it is given there such that one base edge is inclined to HP at 45 degrees. I told you whatever the condition is given with VP, we have to take the same condition with XY. So what we will do, let's say I'm going to start from here, right? And after that, I'm giving a gap. Any gap you can give because it is not given in the question, right? So I'm going to make the object here, taking this gap. Now angle is given 45. So what I'll do, I take the same angle with XY, means for square from this side, if I take 45 angle this side, so if this side 45, here will also be 45 because we know square will have 90 degree angle. So on both side I have taken 45 angle. Now base edge is given 20. So from this point, taking this 20 base edge, so I have taken this one side, which is 45 to the VP, or we can say to the XY. Same, I have to take 20 on this side, right? Now after that, I have to complete the polygon. So how will we complete? Either you can take 90 degree or this, or you can use the compass. There is no particular rule to make that. You can use any rule like I'm doing here with the help of compass. So I have drawn the arcs, and then I'm going to match these arcs. So I got this point, and similarly this point. So this is the top view, right? Now we will make the front view. But in the top view of a square pyramid, if I say a square prism is there, you can see the difference in these two. If this, so when you see from the top, you can see only a square. But when a square pyramid is there, pyramid means it will have one apex point like this. So when you see the top of this object, not this one, when you see the top view of this object, it no doubt it will be a square, but it will have an apex point, and the lines, these lines, the face edges, these face edges will be joining from the apex to the base corners like this. So it means apex to the base corner. You can see these lines also. Here there was no line, here it was a plain square only, but here it will have these lines also, which is joining apex to the base corner. So it means in this I have to make the edges also directly. If I join with the opposite corners, I'll get the face edges. So in actual, this is the top view of the required square pyramid. So I'll do the numbering here. It is 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm using the same rule, anti-clockwise, extreme left corner. So here when we give the numbering of a square prism, it was having 1, 2, 3, 4. At the base you were giving A, B, C, D, right? But in a square pyramid, when you give numbering like this, there is no other corner. you have given numbering to the base corners, no other corner, only apex is there at the top, so you can give only O. So alphabet and numeral both will not come in this case, means only the numerals, no ABCD, right? So here you can give the name to the apex. This is the apex point, right? Now we will go for the front view. Use this concept in all the case of pyramid. I have taken the projections on XY line. Now the height is given 50. So axis height is 50. Now in the case of pyramids, remember that always we have to identify the axis. So what will be the axis? Remember that. If a square pyramid is there, axis will always be center of the base to the apex. The line which join apex to the center of the base, that will be known as axis. So when you see from the top, this apex, this will be, means this point, it will have the axis. So I will directly take, when I'll take, it will come exactly from the 4. So it means if I take this side, it will also the axis. Height is given 50, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so I am taking height 50. So this is also the axis as well as this is the edge also. So when you see from this side, 1 and 2, two face edges or base edges or faces will is visible. So it means here you have to, when you, now this is the apex point, when you will join this, it will be dark up to this and this will be dark. And this will be dark. Why? Because in the front view you can see the two base edges and two faces. So this will also be the dark portion, right? If you are not understanding this, I'll show you here. Now as per the given question, you are watching from this side, so this is VP, this is HP, this is VP. When you see from this side, you can see this type of shape, means you can see this surface one and second surface. So you can see one and two, two faces will be visible, same like here. Now we will develop this. Before that we should give the numbering. So one, so it will be one dash. I have explained the numbering style in your last videos, in a number of videos, so do watch all those videos. It will be very clear how I'm giving the numbering. Same concept like parallel line method, same method, same rule, right? Now after that we have to develop. You remember what we did in parallel line method? Take any gap and then equal to four sides, so four base edges on this line. In radial line we will do the same step, but not parallelly, we take it radially. I'll tell you what is that. Now what we have to do in parallel line, you have taken this gap, any gap here. But in radial line method, you will take the same gap, or I can say any gap here. Means rather than taking the gap here, you will take the gap from apex parallel to this apex, any gap. Let's say this is the point O, right? After that, from this point, you have to make the arc. What will be the radius of that arc? Radius of that arc will be the outermost slant height. Now here the outermost slant height is O dash 3 dash. You have to open the compass, outermost slant height, either O dash 3 dash or O dash 1 dash, means you have to open up to this. But you have to verify, is this height is a true slant height? How you will verify? You have to check in the front view and top view, means O dash 3 dash, this slant height, where is O dash 3 dash in top view? This one, O 3. This slant height will be the true slant height if the same in top view is parallel to XY line. Remember this thing, O dash 3 dash, outermost slant height, we have to check is it the true slant height. We will go for the top view. In top view, O 3 edge, same O 3 edge, it is parallel to XY line, this is XY line, it is parallel to XY line, so it means this is the true slant height. Similarly, O dash 1 dash in top view, this is O 1, it is also parallel to XY, so this is also the true slant height. We will solve few questions where it will not come parallel, then how to make it parallel and how to get the true slant height, I will discuss in that question. So here it is directly coming true slant height, what to do, open the compass equal to that much radius. You can see I'm taking that radius. Now from that point draw the arc. We don't know the length of this arc, so you can take any length, but try to cut it on this line where it is cutting, like this. So draw the arc. We don't know the length of this arc, so I can make the any length. After that, the extra part we will erase later on, right? Now this is the radial structure. On this we have to do the same procedure what we have done in parallel line method in this way. Now we will do it in this way. So I told you base edge, it is square, so four edges will come, four base edges. So you have to start from that point where it has cut with this line, means this is your one point, right? I will join this first. So you can see this is our first edge, right? After that you have to take this base edge. Now it is a square, it means four times the same surface will come, 1, 2, 3, and I got the fourth surface like this, right? After that you have no need to take this extra arc, you can erase that. Now we will join all the points which you have marked with the apex. Like this. Then this arc is light, it should be light. You have to join the edges, the corners of these base edges, like a straight line. Put the scale and you have to just open it like this. You can see this is 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is again 1, right? So this is the front view of the square pyramid, this is the top view of the square pyramid. This is known as development of square pyramid. I'll show you with an example. So first I will complete this, then I will show you with the example so that I can make it more clear. Now I have to do the dimensioning. I have to give the dimension to one base edge, so I'm giving one base edge here. This is the side which is given in question, that is 20. Here we have the axis height, it is given over there, that is 50. Use the proper letter writing style. This is the front view, this is the top view, and this is the development of surface. Now we will give the dimension to the developed area also. First you have to give the dimension to this slant height, how much the radius you have taken for the arc. It will not be given in the question, you have to measure this and write the value. So it is coming approximately 52, so you will write the 52 value here. And then you have to give the dimension to this, the developed area, means how much arc, how much length of arc you have taken. I have just taken the extension lines. Now I'm going to make the arc, take the from same point, and more than that draw the arc. This is just a way to represent how much radial length you have taken on this side. So this is n into b, same method. Now n is 4 because it is a square, b is 20, so this is 80, like this. So this is the solution. Now I will explain this with an example. You can see how we are getting the surfaces like this and development like this. Now I will discuss the same question in the other form. You can see here it is actually a square pyramid. I have made a paper square pyramid. Now it is present like this, and one base edge is inclined to VP. So I have taken this base edge inclined VP like this. Now when I put, what you can see in the top view, you can see the apex and you can see the lines joining the apex to the base corner, same like this. Now you can see this top view. So I have drawn the same top view, you can see here I have drawn the same top view like this, right? And what will be the front view when you rotate? Means this is the top view. When you rotate, what will be the front view? It will be like this. Two faces visible. You can see we have done the same. Two faces visible. You have done the same with base edge like this. Right now, when I cut and unfold, now after that development is cutting and unfolding, means we are cutting one base edge. So same here, what we did, we cut it from here, and after cutting we have developed this thing. So when you cut and unfold, you will have these edges, face edges, these base edges straight, but in a radial way. So we have done the same in the radial way as per the dimensions. This is the slant height. Radius of this will be the slant height, the outermost slant height. So that is why in the front view you have taken this arc, this radius, and you have drawn this arc. So this is the development of surface. So this is the best example. You can understand it by cutting and unfolding. We are making the square pyramid like this.